Hey, good afternoon, everybody. So walking around, looking at some of the things that are going on in the classrooms, we got kids that are coming back here on October 19th. We've already got three kids back in our building today with Ms. Fascione's students. And then tomorrow, we've got the district coming over to do some videotaping in Olivia McEverly's classroom to help broadcast and share with the district what some of the teaching will look like when we do synchronous shared instruction. So today, walking by Mr. Jones' room, saw some of the things that he's doing with video monitors in his classroom. Ms. McEverly and I came in here and looked at that. Was sort of impressed by this. So I wanted to share with you today what he's doing. So here's Mr. Jones, and he's going to share with us how he's got these monitors set up, and he's going to share with us how he uses these monitors in his classroom. And again, this is just one idea. There's a lot of great things that are happening out in the classrooms. So this is just one of the great ideas to try to help add something to your toolbox during this time.
All right, so you can see I've got three screens set up here. We've got some of these desktop monitors around the school that used to be used in the computer lab that you probably could get from Ms. Harris or Ms. Turchan. And the way that I use this is I have my laptop act as my kind of control station where I have CTLS teacher view, Zoom call is active through there. On this screen, I will have the grid of all of the students and their camera feed so that I can see it. And then up on the main touch screen, I'll have the content that I'm showing and be sharing that touch screen out to the Zoom call so that both web students in the classroom and the ones that are on the Zoom call are gonna see the same thing.
Brian, is this hard to set up?
Not really, it's just a few clicks, a few things in the settings, making sure that you have the screens in the right order, which is in our, just in your regular settings under our display settings. And then doing the right thing in Zoom, there's a couple settings that I could show you if you needed help with that, things like enabling dual monitors and sharing the correct screen. But Zoom is pretty self-explanatory with that, but if you need help, I can definitely help you set that up.
Okay. All right, so Brian, thank you so much. And again, if you are interested in setting up a system like this and you do not have a third monitor, if you will reach out to me and let me know, I'll see what I can do to help you out. And if you have questions on the technical aspects, please don't hesitate to reach back out to this superstar right here. All right. Thank you, Mr. Jones. Have a great day, everybody.